Khan Market is known as one of the most commercial and expensive real estate areas in Asia. But what it is not known for is that a hub of mafia control this shopping region. These are primarily old car sales companies and illegal car repair stores. It is illegal to repair cars like these in Delhi as it pollutes the groundwater. These places exist on the sides of the road, following no environmental norms and function primarily under the protection of Delhi police. These auto sales shops also occupy public parking, and they believe as if they own the parking area outside their shops. They behave like goons if somebody tries to park the car outside their shop. Now, what happened to Insya and her husband in Khan Market is just shocking. Let's hear what happened to them.
My husband, myself, and a friend of ours who was visiting us from Canada, we had gone sightseeing that day. We had gone to Akshardham Temple, we were showing him around. And then on the way back, we decided to stop at Khan Market for a bite to eat. Now, we had entered from the Prithviraj Market side, which is where the auto sales guys had their little shops and things like that. So as we entered, we were looking for a spot to park our car. Now, I spotted one on my left, but it was the spot was in such a manner that I had to go forward and then reverse my car into the spot. So I asked my husband to step out of the car. Now, unfortunately, the car that he was standing in front of, which we later identified as a car belonging to Jagat Auto Sales, driven by the main accused, Inder Singh Aswal. He got really aggressive and he got really impatient at being asked to wait. And he drove the car into my husband's leg. Words were exchanged, angry words were exchanged. And then Shaurya started walking back towards the car. Now, as he was walking back towards the car, I saw this driver calling out to a few people and shouting threats and obscenities and things like that. And I saw a few mechanics and other people who worked in that auto place, cleaners perhaps and mechanics, they started walking towards us. There were about 10 of them. So, and I didn't feel safe at all. So I asked Shaurya to get back in the car, and we were trying to leave. We were trying to get out of there. So Shaurya gets back in the car, and we are trying to inch out of there. I'm trying to bring the car out, and it was just not possible because all these people, they had suddenly surrounded us. There were about 10 or 15 of them, and they were so aggressive. Some people, I heard somebody even say, ki paise nikalo, but at that point we were just trying to get out of there, so we weren't really looking around to identify people or anything. So as I started to drive out, and I found a little spot where I felt like I could just get out of there, this driver comes running from my right side with a metal rod and smashes my front windscreen. At that point I just accelerated and tried to just get out of there. But because you know it was Khan Market at 5 PM in the evening, there's so much traffic, I wasn't able to get very far. This guy, he caught up with me again and he smashed my back windscreen, which completely shattered. By now we had reached right in front of the police chowki in Khan Market. And somebody put a car in front of us, and another one behind us, which completely trapped us, and we couldn't get out of there at all. So now we're trapped between these two cars. And there's a mob of about 70 to 100 people just attacking us from all sides. There were metal rods, there were wickets, cricket wickets, there were bats, I don't know, all kinds of weapons that they were using, trying to break the four windows so that they could pull us out, drag us out. And it was a murderous attack. I have no doubt that we would not have survived this attack if they would have gotten in the car. Since it was in front of the police chowki, the police had also arrived. But it took them about half an hour to control this mob. While we were inside the car, being attacked by all these people, we were making frantic phone calls to all our friends and family who live in that area, trying to see if anybody could come and help us. Luckily, one of our lawyer friends was able to arrive on the scene and work with the police to form a perimeter around us so that we could exit the car safely, so that the mob couldn't get to us. And then we were escorted into the police station, where we proceeded to file our complaint and get an FIR registered. So the police has filed an FIR, but unfortunately it has been diluted. The sections that have been applied are not reflective of our complaint. They're very minor sections, very minor offences, and they've only arrested 5 people so far. It's been about 10 days and only 5 people have been picked up who have been let out on bail the very next day because the FIR is, you know, very minor offences they've been charged with.
Now what are we asking the Delhi police? Why have you filed a weak FIR? This is a mob. And it clearly shows that the person who attacked the car did it with a brick or a stone. which could have easily killed somebody. Why are then all the accused out on bail? When will the Delhi police arrest all the attackers?